Namaskar. Let us start today's session. Today we will learn what is electric flux. Before learning electric flux, let us understand what is flux. So let us take an example. So consider this area. Okay, this is the area. So if I place it like this, consider flow of some liquid through this area in a direction normal, perpendicular to this plane. So what is the rate of flow of liquid at this point? It is given by the volume of liquid crossing this area per unit time. This represents the flux of liquid flowing across this plane. We define a similar quantity in case of electric field and call it electric flux. Of course, in the case of electric field, there is nothing physically flowing through this area, but there is electric field. How do we represent electric field? By electric field lines. We have learned that. So we'll understand the electric flux in terms of electric field lines crossing an area at that point. We have already learned that the number of field lines crossing a unit area, which is kept normal to the field at a point, tells us about the measure of the strength of the electric field at that point. So say for example, if I consider this area, let me consider it as delta S, and it is kept normal to the direction of electric field. So the number of field lines crossing this area is proportional to the product of E and delta S. Now, why did I say proportional and not equal to? We have already learned this. What is significant is the relative number of field lines crosses this area at different points. Say for example, if I consider this plane which is perpendicular to the direction of electric field. Let me consider this area as delta S. So when I place this area normal to the direction of electric field, the number of field lines crossing this area is maximum. But if I tilt it, then the number of electric field lines crossing this area is less. So what is that area which will be the projected area of this on this vertical? Right? How much will it be? So let me remove this field line just to avoid confusion. So what it will be if I consider this length, say length was there, which was y, and if I tilt it, okay, at an angle theta, then I have to project this y on the vertical, and the projection of y on the vertical, that will be this, right? This distance. That will be equal to, say, let it be x. Then how do I find this? So cos of theta will be equal to x upon y. Hence, the projection of y on the vertical is equal to y cos theta. Similarly, the projection of this area delta S on the vertical will be this. So this will be, this area will be normal to the direction of electric field. And how much will it be? That will be equal to delta S cos theta. Hence, the number of field lines crossing the area delta S is proportional to E into delta S into cos theta. Right? That means what we understand, that not only the magnitude but orientation of area element is also important. This implies that we have to treat the area element as a vector. Now, which direction should we consider as the direction of area element. So if you consider this, this is the area, suppose delta S, then the normal to that area is considered as the direction of this area as a vector. We call it area vector. So this normal is the area vector. So when I tilt this area delta S by an angle theta, the area vector also makes an angle theta with the direction of electric field. So what we understood just now can be understood in or expressed in terms of area vector. So instead of saying what is the projection of this area on the vertical, which is perpendicular to the direction of electric field, I can also say what is the component of this normal area vector in the direction of electric field and work it out. To understand this, let us see an animation.
Suppose this is was an area which was normal to the direction of electric field. So area vector was along the electric field. Now here you can see it is slightly at an angle. It is at an angle. If I have some angle made by the area with the vertical plane, then the area vector also makes the same angle with the electric field. So if I move it like this, the area is making an angle. The same angle is made by the area vector, has also made an angle with the electric field. So if I make it more, again area vector is also making an angle with the electric field. So this is what will happen. So if I take this as theta, this angle is also theta. Okay, so we denote the area, suppose as delta S, then I'll say it is the delta S is the magnitude and I'll multiply it with a unit vector in the direction of area vector. Okay, area vector is always normal to the area. So if delta S is the surface area which we consider, then delta S, vector delta S, is equal to magnitude multiplied by the unit vector which I have denoted by N, where delta S is the magnitude of the area element and N unit is a unit vector in the direction of outward normal at that point. Now electric flux we denote generally by phi symbol, Greek alphabet phi. So delta phi, that means because I'm dividing a whole area into small areas, small area delta S. Suppose A is the full area, I'll divide it into small areas, which is delta S. So I'll say the flux coming out from there will be delta phi. So how do we define delta phi? So we have the flux delta phi is equal to E dot delta S. It is E dot delta S. It is a dot product of two vectors because flux is a scalar. So dot product of two vectors is a scalar. So vector E dot vector delta S. Now what does it mean? That it is E into delta S into cos of that angle. So theta is the angle between electric field and the area vector. Therefore, the total flux phi is given by phi is almost equal to summation of E dot delta S. So total flux through that whole area will be sum of the flux through each area. Okay, let us see what is electric dipole. As I have already mentioned, two equal and opposite charges, say plus Q and minus Q, they are equal and opposite in charge. Two equal and opposite charges separated by some distance is called a dipole. So we consider the distance between them as 2a. And there is a direction of the dipole. So direction of the dipole is considered along the line joining the two charges, and it is from minus Q to plus Q, negative charge to positive charge. That is the direction of electric dipole. So let us start. It is a pair, as I mentioned, it is a pair of equal and opposite point charges, Q and minus Q, separated by a distance 2a. By convention, the direction from minus Q to plus Q is said to be the direction of the dipole. The midpoint of the minus Q and plus Q is called the center of the dipole. So if this is a dipole, I'll say this is the center of the dipole, and this forms, I've kept it vertical, it can be kept horizontal also. All right. Net charge on them, total charge on a dipole, of course it is zero, but that does not mean the electric field is zero. Electric field exists. But if you have take a point very far away from, with respect to the distance of the dipole, means that r distance, suppose I take a point which is at a distance r from the dipole, then if that r is far greater than this 2a, then of course the field will reduce to negligible value. Let us find out the expression for the field of an electric dipole. We can find the electric field at a point on the axis of the dipole. Also, we can find electric field at a point on the equatorial plane of a dipole. So let us get started for a point on the axis. So let us first consider a charge plus Q and a charge minus Q. This is a line joining the two charges. The distance between the charges is 2a. We represent it as 2a. The dipole direction is from minus Q to plus Q. We represent this as p, small p, vector sign. It is called the dipole moment. We will look into that little later. So let us consider this a point P on the axis of a dipole at a distance r from the center of the dipole. So what will be the direction of electric field due to this minus Q charge at this point? So that will be in this direction. What will be the direction of electric field due to this plus Q charge at this point? It is in this direction. Now, you have seen the length of this vector is more than the length of this vector. What does it suggest? That electric field at this point due to plus Q is more than the electric field at this point due to this charge minus Q, because this is nearer and this is further apart. Okay, so let us, so I am just describing, whenever you are doing a derivation, you have to understand this diagram and draw it, and then you have to write the description. So you have to describe the situation. So consider a point P at a distance r from the center of the dipole on the same side of charge Q as shown in the figure. So let us see what will be the value of the electric field at point P due to charge minus Q. What it will be? We have already studied what is the expression for that. So let us write that expression. It is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q upon r plus a the whole square. The direction of this electric field due to this minus q charge is opposite to the direction of the dipole moment, or opposite to the direction of dipole. That's why this minus sign. Where from we get this r plus a? The distance is r to up to the center, distance of P up to center is r, plus a, half the dipole distance, okay, that is a, the whole square, into unit vector P. where P is a unit vector along the dipole axis. Similarly, because P is from minus Q to plus Q and this direction of electric field is opposite to that, that's why minus sign. So similarly, E plus Q will be Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R minus A the whole square, because the distance of P from charge plus Q is R minus A into the unit vector P. The total field will be, what will be the total field at point P due to this dipole together? If I consider plus Q and minus Q, this is a dipole, forming a dipole. So what is the electric field at point P due to this dipole? So what I'll have to do, I'll have to add these two. So let me add it. So E will be, total field E at point P will be electric field due to charge plus Q plus electric field due to charge minus Q. When I add the two, I have this common factor, which is Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 into the bracket. This is what I got. If I solve this bracketed part, what do you get? So we have total electric field is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0. We get this inside because I have the square of R plus A the whole square minus the square of R minus A the whole square. And denominator you have this. So you see R square cancels with this R square. This A square cancels with this A square. What remains is 4RA. So what do you get final expression? E is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 4AR upon R square minus A square the whole square into unit vector P. Now here this is the expression for electric field at a point on the axis of a dipole. And the electric, total electric field is in the direction of the dipole. Total electric field is in the direction of the dipole, not opposite. It is in the same direction as the dipole. Now, if we consider a short dipole, that means the R is much greater than A, half the dipole distance. So, if R is greater than A, then I can neglect A in the denominator and what I get is E is equal to 4QA upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R cube into unit vector P. So, this is the expression. If R is far greater than A, then electric field is 4QA upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R cube into unit vector P. We define dipole moment vector P of an electric dipole as Q into 2A into unit vector P. So what is the magnitude of dipole moment? It is the charge multiplied by the distance between the two charges. That is 2A. So 2A into Q gives you the magnitude of the dipole moment. In terms of dipole moment, we can define, we can describe, or we can write the expression for electric field. What it will be? Electric field will be equal to 2 times the dipole moment upon this. So what do you get? E is equal to 2 times dipole moment. Of course, it's a vector because the dipole, the magnitude multiplied by the unit vector, there is a unit vector. So if I say magnitude 2QA multiplied by this gives me a vector. So I write it in the vector notation, 2P upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R cube. Of course, R is far greater than A.
That's all for today's session. I'm sure you must have understood and enjoyed learning and deriving the expression for electric field. If you like my video, please hit the like button and do subscribe my channel. See you next time.